Mr. Toastmaster and fellow Toastmasters. Sunday afternoon, 4 o'clock, just a few days ago, I was pacing the lobby downstairs of a high-rise building, commercial building. I was pondering, anxiously, pretty nervous. You know, that feeling just like before you get on a roller coaster ride, you're wondering that, should I do this or maybe not? Yeah, why do I want to torture myself and induce a heart attack? Maybe I can just back off and get to the back of the line and pretend nobody sees me. But then I said it to myself, why not? Before I knew it, I was in front of a group of theater professionals, in front of spotlight, in front of cameras. I was in an audition for a role, a real theater thing, just so you know, for a role in a play called My Asian Mom. Well, why not? Of course! I'm Asian! I can play an Asian role, right? Yes, but I don't know if my Asian accent is heavy enough to play it at all. I can be a mom, of course. I am not a mom. I don't even have a husband. The mom always said it's the older thing. I have to get a husband and then get a kiss. But whatever, I can still play that role. I remember how my mom been interacting with me. I can do that, but I don't know. Asian mom supposed to have like longer hair and with kind of a little, you know, a belly. I don't know how to describe that. A little persona. I don't have that persona. What? So that's why I was pondering. And I don't know. Should I just really make a fool of myself and go in front of those professional actors and actresses and directors and really do the role? I don't know if I should go upstairs. But then I thought, yeah, this is an opportunity probably once in a lifetime. I don't know if I'm gonna do it ever again. No. So why not? So I went upstairs, was in front of the group of folks, in front of spotlight, I was reading a script. With my son, looks way more professional than me, I placed my son that, you know, when your mom say no, that means no. Disobey your mom is disrespectful. I suck. I didn't get the role. But I'm glad I did it. The same feeling like if you drive 5 hours to Six Flags and then finally in front of the roller coaster, right? Would you just sit aside and watch people play? Watch people get excited or getting heart attack on the roller coaster? No, you go on and play. That's how I felt. You know, so many times, and I'm not bragging, but I'm the one that's so smart. I'm the type that's so smart, I can always talk myself out of anything. So why would I want to do this? It's not good for you. I'm too old, I'm too young, I'm too short, I'm too Asian, I don't have experience. Yeah, of course, but why not? Fellow Toastmasters, what's that something you always wanted to do, but not sure if you're ready to take the risk? Instead of trying to come up with the excuse and the reason and why shouldn't you do it, how about ask a different question? Mr. Toastmaster.
Julia, I've missed you.
Yes, yes, yes.
Welcome back. Pluses, I love the vocal variety. I love the body language, especially the shaking of the paper in the hand. What I would have liked to have heard more when you were shaking that paper, more shaking in your voice to match it. Because the paper was going, but your voice was still a little steady. So those are the things I would comment.
Julia, I thought your speech overall was very well done. It was certainly very humorous and very convincing. Because you make challenge ourselves as to why, think about why we shouldn't do something instead of, often we figure out why not to do it, really. So often we make excuses for not doing anything. But your speech challenges us to not make those excuses. The one area I thought they could have used improvement was toward the beginning in the lobby. I wasn't quite sure what was happening in your speech. You quite jumped on the subject right away. But overall, it was an excellent speech because it was funny and made us think about why we look for excuses to avoid doing things.
Some great things that I think you possess as a speaker. Cynthia already touched on your vocal variety, I think, is outstanding. You have a great amount of enthusiasm and energy up there, and you command a certain type of stage presence when you get on the stage. One thing I would like to say as a growth opportunity, I think you could have brought us in a little stronger. Could have maybe talked about, we just talked about audience and how to cater things to your audience. Maybe you could have talked about the fear of public speaking in general, with this being a Toastmasters club. And then that would have drew us in a lot more, we would have been more engaged. We would have kind of knew potentially where you were going with this. But overall, I thought it was a great speech, a great lesson. I think a lot of people need to think, why not, and go ahead and do things. And I enjoyed your speech.
Thank you.